Good morning.
Welcome to the First Baptist Church of Bedford. Special welcome to any visitor that is worshiping with us this morning. You know, there's no enemy in our... We're all friends, so welcome. There are several announcements. Let us prepare our hearts and minds to worship by a period of meditation and music. Stand and join, if you're able, and join in the call to worship. We remember the countless saints who have run the race before us. When we are weary and in need of strength, when we are lost and sick at heart, when we have decisions that are difficult to make, as long as we live, they too will live, for they are now a part of us.
We remember them.
We are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses. Let us also lay aside every weight and the sin that clings to close so closely.
Amen. Let us run with perseverance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus,
Amen.
fellowship in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give us grace so to follow your faithful in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those ineffable joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who offend us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Responsively, Psalm 34, verses 1 through 10. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth.
My soul makes its boast in the Lord. Let the humble hear and be glad.
Will magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together.
Exalt the Lord.
Look to him and be radiant, so your faces shall never be ashamed.
His faithful will cry, and never forget the Lord, and his saving are never troubled.
The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them.
O taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy
Fear the Lord, you his holy ones, for those who fear him have no want. The epistle lesson appointed for today is found in the first letter of John, the third chapter. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. Amen. And the gospel lesson appointed for today is found in the gospel according to Matthew, the fifth chapter. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain. And after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when people revile you, persecute you, and utter all kinds of false evil against you on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. I would now invite the candidate for holy baptism to come forward, as well as Ruth and Cliff, members of the diaconate. Holy baptism will now be presented.
We present you for us to receive the ring of
our Ruth and Cliff, deacons in the Church of Jesus Christ, if you have found Jafford worthy to receive the rite of holy baptism, answer, "We have."
We have.
Jafford, do you desire to be baptized?
I do.
Do you renounce all evil and powers in the world which defy God's righteousness and love? Do you renounce the ways of sin that separate you from the love of God?
I renounce them with God's help.
Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior?
I do with God's help.
Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love?
I do with God's help.
Do you promise to follow and obey him as your Lord?
I do with God's help.
I would invite the whole congregation to stand and to share together in the baptismal promises on the blue insert. Do you, as members of the Church of Jesus Christ, promise to guide and nurture Jafford in word and deed, with love and prayer, encouraging him to know and follow Christ and to be a faithful member of his church?
We do, with God's help.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
We do, with God's help.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
We do, with God's help.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Universal Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
We do with God's help.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread, and in the prayers?
We do with God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil? And whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord. Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ? Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbors as yourself? Will you strive for justice and peace among all of God's people, care for all creation, and respect for the dignity of every human being? Hearing these promises, let us proceed with the rite of holy baptism. You may be seated, and the children may come forward.
Thank you.
Jeffwood, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We are buried with him in baptism. We are raised to walk in newness of life. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by the water and the Holy Spirit, you have bestowed on this, your servant, the forgiveness of sins, and raised him to the new life of grace. Sustain him, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give him an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage to will and persevere, a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all of your works. Amen. Jeffwood, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Let us welcome the newly baptized.
Thank you. visiting area churches. He suggested I visit First Baptist Medford because of the wonderful music program. I immediately went home and visited First Baptist Church's vibrant website. I liked what I saw, and I was happy to read, "Worship services are formal and adhere to rich New England Protestant tradition." The grace of God brought me to First Baptist Church Medford. I vividly remember it was a beautiful spring Sunday morning this past May when I made my first visit. As I approached the front entrance, the door was opened for me, and I was greeted with a warm and friendly, "Good morning. Thank you so much, Mr. Fred Ross." As I entered this beautiful sanctuary, I was embraced by a cloak of love, rich ethnic diversity, and beautiful music. Mr. Alan Rogers extended another warm, friendly welcome as he handed me the worship service program. "Thank you so much, Mr. Rogers, for how you made me feel." My mind perceived First Baptist Medford as a church community filled with God's children and a celebration of Christian love, each of which has filthiness. And when I looked into the sanctuary, I saw this beautiful tapestry of parishioners that were guided and molded by a master weaver sent to us by God, Reverend Matt Rashaw. Each of Reverend Matt's sermons is theology-based, founded on scripture, and we, the congregants, learn and better understand how not only we, but the local and global communities have the delicate and helpful threads that are interwoven into this beautiful tapestry of Christian love at First Baptist Church Medford. I'm ever mindful that perception is reality. This is real. In closing, I share these much-loved words from Mother Teresa. "Love is a fruit in season. It's seasoned at all times and within reach of every hand." Thank you.
Come now to the time of congregational prayer, and as we do, I call your attention to all of those names listed or printed in the bulletin. In addition to these, on this All Saints Day, we are mindful of all of the lives through all of the years that have touched our own and shaped our faith. We will have a time of pause, a time of silence in the middle of the prayer, and I would invite each person to say out loud the name of those whom God lays on your heart now, who have shaped whom you have become and have made your life of faith better. Let us pray. Almighty and most holy God, we are reminded on this day of the communion of all of those who have believed in you through all of the centuries, through all of the millennia. We pray to you, O God, for your church throughout the world, that you may confirm it in faith, sustain it in hope, and deepen its communion in charity. We pray, O God, for those who wield earthly power, that they may recognize in the disciples of Jesus, children of God, anxious to serve in building up the earthly city. We pray to you, O God, for those beset by persecution for righteousness' sake, and those weighed down by trial and distress, that the example of the saints before them may give them courage, and the help of believers today give them hope. We pray, O God, for this assembly gathered to celebrate your holy communion around your table. We gather with the church in heaven and throughout the world that nourished by your word of truth and the bread of life, we may bear witness in our own generation to the timeless gospel of your love. We pray, O God, for those who have departed this life in faith and fear of you, that they may join in the innumerable throng of holy ones gathered before the throne and the Lamb. We pray especially for those we name now. Bob.
Virginia Rogers.
Mom and Dad.
Herman Johnson.
Donald Touch.
Herman Jackson.
Constance Crutchman.
Lewis and Peter Beckwith.
For all of those named here today, for those we name in the silence of our hearts, and for those with no one left on this side of eternity to bear their names, we lift them and commend them before you, Almighty God. Holy God, mighty God, immortal God, adored by angels and praised by the faithful, receive the prayers of your holy church and grant these in accordance with your gracious will, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Imagination. He saw a multitude who could not be numbered, clothed in white, waving palm branches in their hands. Angels and elders and beasts surrounded the throne of God. And all of the inhabitants of heaven were locked in songs of perpetual praise. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to God forever. Again and again and again, the song goes on for all eternity. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever. John points to something great that is beyond the realm
of what is possible to know. And it is easy for us to get lost in the details of the landscape and the fantastic characters in John's vision. John might have been lost in these details too. But an elder in the vision came to him and directed his attention, and indeed our attention, toward what is most important. The elder asked John, "Who are these, robed in white, and where have they come from?" John didn't know the answer. So the elder continued, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. Freed from the trials and difficulties and pain of life, the multitude without number now lives at peace. They drink from the springs of the water of life. They eat at the table of God. God wipes every tear from their eyes." John's vision of the multitude clothed in white offered hope to Christians who received his letter. John was in prison for his faith, exiled to an island off the coast of Greece called Patmos. Others like him faced prison, faced unfair punishment, and faced great challenges because of their faith. And John offered to them this vision of hope, of the multitude clothed in white around the throne of God. And this very vision has lifted the Christian imagination through the centuries in the face of adversity. It has lifted the Christian imagination to heights of courage, heights of charity, and heights of faithfulness. On this holy day in the Christian year, we remember those who have walked the great ordeal of life ahead of us and who give light to our way. So who are these robed in white, and where have they come from? They are Perpetua and Felicity of Carthage, who in the year 202 declared to their families, "I am a Christian." When threatened with jail, they stood fast and were sentenced by the Roman authorities to death by wild animals. With their dying breath, they cried, "Stand fast in the faith, love one another." Who are these clothed in white, and where have they come from? They are Bernard of Clairvaux, who in the 12th century strove to be good and charitable, who held back nothing of his great fortune for himself, and used every last cent for the common good. It was he who wrote, "O sacred head now wounded," a hymn we still sing every Holy Week. Who are these clothed in white, and where have they come from? They are Elizabeth Cady Stanton and Amelia Bloomer. They are Sojourner Truth and Harriet Tubman, women who were liberators and prophets, fighting against injustice toward women and injustice toward people of color. They suffered for their work, but they persisted toward their goal. Who are these clothed in white, and where have they come from? They are Roger Williams and Anne Hutchinson, who were run out of the colony of Massachusetts for pursuing religious freedom and the separation of church and state. They are Absalom Jones, who fought against segregation in the American church. They are Clive Staples Lewis, who struggled throughout his life to believe in God and is now one of the most beloved Christian authors of our time. They are Dietrich Bonhoeffer, who resisted the evils of the Nazi regime and led a church-based movement against them, resulting in his imprisonment it is death. Who are these clothed in white, and where have they come from? They are the matriarchs and patriarchs of this parish. They are the Sunday school teachers and ushers, the choir members and kitchen workers, the deacons and the groundskeepers. Occasionally, they might have been the ministers. They are those who told us the stories of God's love, who taught us the responsibilities and joys of life in community, who shared their hope with us. Who are these clothed in white? And where have they come from? They are the children of God. In the epistle lesson today from 1 John, we hear these words. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. John's vision of hope in the book of Revelation is meant for us today, here and now. The line between saint and sinner is blurry. It always has been. It always will be. The great ordeal of life is filled with broken and imperfect people coming to God to find meaning and purpose for their lives and in the light of God's love. The faithful we honor today are women and men of the past and of our own time who somehow allowed God to use them, imperfections and all. The saints of our lives are those who lead us to the love of God, who stand against hate, who carry us when we struggle, who call us out when we make mistakes, who encourage us, and who offer hope in the love of God. The voice of this multitude clothed in white has pointed us to the hope of our faith. May we also be faithful every single day to point others, friends and enemies alike, to the good news of God's love for them. See what love the Father has given to us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. Amen. This is the Lord's table. It is not our own. All are welcome here. Come, all is now made ready for you. Let us confess our sin to Almighty God. Merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart, mind, and strength. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. As far as east is from the west, so far has God removed our sin from us. Know then that in the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Let us offer thanksgiving to the Lord our God. It is truly right and our greatest joy to give you thanks and praise, O Lord our God, creator and ruler of the universe. In your wisdom, you made all things and sustained them by your power. You formed us in your image, setting us in the world to love and serve you
to live in peace with your whole creation. When we rebelled against you, refusing to trust and obey you, you did not reject us, but still claimed us as your own. You sent prophets to call us back to your way. Then, in the fullness of time, out of your great love for the world, you sent your only Son to be one of us, to redeem us and heal our brokenness. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with choirs of angels, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all the faithful of every time and place, who forever sing to the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are holy, O God of majesty, and blessed is Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. In Jesus, born of Mary, your word became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. He lived as one of us, knowing joy and sorrow. He healed the sick, fed the hungry, opened blind eyes, broke bread with outcasts and sinners, and proclaimed the good news of your kingdom to the poor and needy. Dying on the cross, he gave himself for the life of the world. Rising from the grave, he won for us victory over death. Seated at your right hand, he leads us to eternal life. We praise you that Christ now reigns with you in glory and will come again to make all things new. We give you thanks that the Lord Jesus, on the night before he died, took bread. And after giving thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this in remembrance of me." Remembering your gracious acts in Jesus Christ, we take from your creation this bread and wine, and joyfully celebrate his dying and rising as we await the day of his coming. With thanksgiving, we offer our very selves to you to be a living and holy sacrifice dedicated to your service. Let us proclaim the mystery of our faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Gracious God, pour out your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts of bread and wine, that the bread we break and the cup we bless may be the communion of the body and blood of Christ. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, that we may be one with all who share this feast, united in ministry in every place. As this bread is Christ's body for us, send us out to be the body of Christ in the world. In union with your church in heaven and on earth, we pray, O God, that you will fulfill your eternal purpose in us and in all the world. Keep us faithful in your service until Christ comes in final victory, and we shall feast with all your saints in the joy of your eternal realm. Through Christ, with Christ, and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
the body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Let us pray. Gracious God, take these our hands that have held the consecrated bread and wine and work through them. Take our lips that have tasted the holy mysteries and speak through them. Take our bodies that have received the symbols of our Lord's most precious body and blood and make them fit temples for your Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us an offering and sacrifice to God.
and of your own we give to you. Bless these gifts. Bless all who have given, and bless all who will receive through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Son and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen.